Today we're here with local artist Lynn Cardwell. She has many talents. She plays the cello, she's a multimedia artist, and she does incredibly beautiful pottery. And today that's what we're going to concentrate on.
Thanks, Casey, for coming to talk to me. We're here at the Davis Center, YMCA, and this is the new art room where I'm teaching pottery classes, both hand building and wheel throwing.
So that's really nice. You're sharing your knowledge. I mean, you really have such beautiful pieces, and you could teach a novice like me.
Sure.
The art of pottery.
Yes, why don't we make a wall vase and then a leaf bowl.
So how much do these blocks of clay weigh?
This block right here is 25 pounds. We're gonna roll out this clay.
All right.
And once it's rolled out all the way, we're going to put a texture on it with this lace tatting that my Nana made. And this is really old, and I've been using the same piece for probably 10, 12 years.
It's amazing. It's so sturdy and beautiful. It looks like it would be so fragile, but it's beautiful.
Thank you. We're gonna roll this out between two sticks, but we don't want just a really long piece of clay. So I'm gonna turn it this way and roll a little bit to get it wider.
Okay.
Okay, now turn it so we can make it longer.
Okay.
Picking it up every once in a while and putting it back down makes it a little easier to roll out. And we're going to put this texture on. You lay it out. And you're just trying to roll it in there deep enough to get the impression.
Wow. That is beautiful. That doesn't even look like that. You know?
Uh-huh.
I mean, it really looks so different.
Yeah.
On that.
It almost looks like alligator skin.
Yeah. Yeah, it does. It looks like a reptile.
And we're going to cut out a piece of clay that's kind of like a heart, but doesn't have a dip there. So I'm drawing this on. And then I'm going to cut through. Whoops.
So we want it to be this shape.
I'm going to cut out the shape I just drew.
Okay, and you want me to make that shape?
Sure.
Is that about right?
Excellent, yes. So now you take your needle point, and you're going to cut all the way through to the table. This is called scoring. Anytime you put two pieces of clay together, you scratch it up.
Okay.
And this is called slip.
And is that like liquefied clay?
It's the same clay body that has water added, so it's gonna act like glue. That looks good.
And then?
Roll this part, start at the top, roll that part over and attach it there, and then work your way down. The only other thing it needs is a couple holes so that you can hang it up.
So what do we do with these now?
This will dry completely, and then we will bisque fire it one time in a kiln to about 1850 degrees. That's called a bisque firing. And then we would use whatever glaze we want to use to paint it on or pour it on, and then fire it one more time to a mid-range stoneware temperature, which is about 2200 degrees. Throw it down and really get it stuck on there. That's the high speed.
Okay.
And then as each step you do, you slow it down a little bit. So centering you do on fast. You add a little water. So the next step is opening it up, making sure you don't go all the way through because you need a bottom to use.
Yes.
I'm gonna open it up a little more.
And it's all with the shape of your hand. It's
yes.
All with your finger.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to add a little water. I'm going to squeeze. It's almost like I'm going to squeeze and start picking up like I have a pea between my fingers. And I'll let it come out a little for a bowl shape. And just make my bowl a little fuller and a little bigger.
Wow, that is beautiful.
Thank
really.
You. Thank you. I can pick this up and move it.
And this is what it will look like after the first firing.
Right, it's called a bisque firing. And that gets rid of all the moisture and organic materials that are in the clay. And it just makes it sturdier to work with so you don't break it when you're glazing it. So there's a lot of reasons to do a bisque firing.
And this is where you would paint it,
yes.
Color it, glaze it, and determine everything.
Right.
Lynn is an artist of the Mahoning Commons, and that you do a lot at the Ward Bakery and the Calvin Center, and they have different shows. But I must admit that I found you on Etsy, etsy.com, which is just a wonderful website.
It's been awesome. I've joined it 4 years ago, and it just keeps growing and growing. I think there's over 400,000 members now. It's a global handmade marketplace.
Well, my sister in Hawaii and my niece, they're going to be getting some Lynn Cardwell pieces for gifts.
Yes, thank you very much.
And this has been amazing. If someone wants to take a class here, what would they do?
They just call 330-480-5656 to find out about upcoming pottery classes at the Davis YMCA.
And you'll get hands-on experience with the master herself. This has been great. I'm dying to see my wall vase.
Me too.
Exercise your mind with the Casey Malone Show. We'll be right back.